Hi, my name is Brishkay Ahmed, and I'm really excited to be here on Ebby's show. Okay, how did it feel?
Let's say, hi, I'm Ebby Mohseni. And thank you so much for sharing this. I was hoping, and I was, I had a wish.
Yes.
To wear one of this.
Yeah.
And feel the Afghan woman.
Yes.
And I felt.
What was the first thing? Did you feel the heat?
First, I want to cry. Still, I have it here. It's hard. It's hard, the human being isolated. It was too much heat under.
Yeah.
And it was difficult to breathe.
Well, do you know that for so many Afghan women, when I was in Afghanistan filming, and when I was there last year, it was 2011 and 2012, when I arrived in Kabul, I expected women to be dressed the way my mother was dressed 50 years ago because the Taliban have gone, right?
Yes.
When I arrived and I went into the market, 80% of the women are still wearing this.
Yes.
And if you ask them to remove it, it's intolerable for them because they've become so accustomed
yes.
to it. And the women who've become accustomed to it are women who are my age.
Yes.
The older generation have removed it because they know that there used to be a time in Afghanistan when women did not wear this.
Yes.
But the younger generation, anybody from 15 up to 45, they think this is what Afghanistan has always been and they think this is normal. That's the saddest part of it all.
Yes. Is there any pressure on the woman to wear this by the community or husband or the society expect that or the government?
You know what? Definitely not by the government because it is not in our constitution.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, right now in the constitution in Afghanistan, I do not have to wear a headscarf if I'm walking around Afghanistan.
Mm-hmm.
And if a police officer stops and asks me, and they did when I was filming there, my first response was, you cannot arrest me, you cannot question me, because in the constitution, I do not have to wear a headscarf. I simply have to wear modest clothing.
Yes.
But what's happened is that this generation that grew up under the Taliban, don't forget, they burnt pictures, they burnt movies, they burnt every single image of what a country used to be.
Mm-hmm.
So they see this as normal, and then they flipped it, and they have made it Islamic.
Yes.
And I think, Ebby, you know from your
yes.
from your background as well, that nowhere in the Quran does it say that the
yes.
entire face has to be covered.
Yes.
Modesty
yes.
is implied, but definitely not to be blinded. But it's become worse now. Do you know why? Okay. Because at least during the Taliban time, it was just the Taliban tailors or they were forcing people to create it.
Okay.
Now, burqas are created in China. So it's become a commercial material. Like
yes.
there's an industry that thrives off it. They've created yellow ones, they've created purple ones, they've created green ones.
Became so a fashion.
Fashionable. Brides wear the white ones and different regions.
Mm-hmm.
So when you have like a big market like China, that's manufacturing this in the
yes.
thousands yearly, it's really scary.
Yes, yes.
It's scary that it's become fashionable.
Yes, it become, yeah. I understand that. So, first of all, just I'm getting back to myself.
Okay, finally.
finally.
Yeah.
And still I'm not back to
yeah.
myself, but I try to. So, I would like to thank you so much for being with us. And tell us about your movie. I have to say, Brishkay Ahmed. She's a filmmaker of Burqa, and this is really appreciated to have time with you. Please
thank you
tell
for
us
having
about
me.
The movie, and what is the Burqa movie about, and I have some other questions.
Okay. Well, my film, The Story of Burqa, Case of a Confused Afghan, will actually screen at the DOXA Documentary Film Festival,
yes.
which is starting up in May. It's one of the biggest Western Canada documentary festivals. It's awesome because I get to head up or kickstart the Canadian Women in Documentary.
Yes.
So it's a great way to go for
yes.
it. I didn't choose the subject matter originally.
Yeah, I want to know why you chose this.
I didn't.
You didn't?
No. It's the weird thing is that sometimes you choose the subjects that you want to film.
Yes.
Sometimes the subjects choose you.
Oh.
And I was editing my last film, and I was sitting next to my father, and my father was, you know, going through my Kabul footage, and he looked at the burqa and he said, "Ugh, this is not an Afghan garment." And I went, "Excuse me, Daddy? What do you mean this is not an Afghan garment? I've been living in Canada, and every CNN and BBC footage that I have seen has been of the blue, and it's connected to Afghanistan."
Yes.
He said, there's a big story behind it. And then he told me the story.
Oh.
And then I was like, okay, I have to make a film about this because it's not a religious garment.
Yes.
But it's actually a political garment. And
yes.
That's what my film explores. It it shines a light on the fact that this is a political tool used to manipulate and manage a society.
Yes.
And whether it's Afghanistan or Yemen or any, you know, extreme Islamic nation, having women covered up to this extreme level makes it a lot easier for the dictators to control a country, because
yes.
half of the society is out of
yes.
it.
Yes. So what is the women of Afghanistan,
yeah.
Their opinion about this? Is it completely accepted, or they are against it, but they are suppressed?
You know what, that question, it's a great question. It's a question also that makes me sad, because so many women in Afghanistan are illiterate. See, they don't know what is right, what is wrong.
Yes.
They listen to fundamentalists in mosques that dictate to them what is.
Mm-hmm.
Women who are literate, who are educated, absolutely are against that. They know that for Afghanistan to evolve, we cannot evolve with this clot. There is no way our nation can move forward and create doctors
yes.
and politicians and nurses or in any manner being with this cloth being
yes.
a daily garment. And 2014 is coming up. We have a presidential candidate who's female, Fawzia Kufi. She's 36 years old. So does she have a chance at winning? I hope so, but not if the women are under this and illiterate still. So the burqa and illiteracy go together.
Yes, if they want to, for example, women, they need to vote, so it's a burqa is giving a vote.
And
so because you don't know who is
who,
under.
Who is under it.
Who is under?
Well, another strange thing, in the Afghan constitution right now, a woman can be a judge.
Okay.
How do you know who is a judge under this burqa?
Yes.
It could be anybody sitting underneath there, and you are not allowed,
yes.
according to
yes.
the Islamic Sharia laws, to ask that judge to lift up the burqa so we can see the face.
Yes.
Or a person, a victim.
Yes.
Or somebody accused of a crime if
yes.
they're under the burqa. It's in 2012 it doesn't make sense to me.
Yes.
I think 200 years ago it wouldn't have made sense to me.
No, never.
Like it just doesn't
never.
Make sense.
Never makes sense. But you know, it was because, as you mentioned, they try to keep, the mullahs,
mm-hmm.
They want to keep people without knowledge what's going on because they are not educated themselves. They need some people don't know. They have to keep you
under control.
Under control. So how they can do it? They have to fool people.
Exactly.
Sharia law was made by Ayatollah Khomeini is not Islamic.
Yes, I know.
Right now,
yeah.
The Iranian government wants to bring this to the world. This is from God. And
yes.
This is the rule by God. And so you want to deny that? You can.
Yeah.
And the whole world should be run by the Sharia law. Sharia law is not from God. It's from Ayatollah Khomeini.
Yeah.
And this is foolish.
Yeah, and they feed off each other.
Yes.
Whether it's from Afghanistan or whether it's in Yemen or in maybe Libya soon or wherever, but they feed off each other. And they do that. You know, but one thing interesting, if you look at it, nowhere in nature, nowhere in the animal kingdom ever, like everyone has that right to like sunlight, to oxygen,
yes.
to air,
yes.
to breathe, to feel
yes.
those beautiful things. And the saddest thing for me was I actually spent time in Iran also, and I went to Shumal, this area of the beach, and I saw all these men jumping into the water and swimming, and I saw these beautiful girls just sitting out there staring at the water
yes.
and not being able to go in.
Yes.
And if they have to go in, they have to go in completely covered. And what joy is that? And the same thing in Afghanistan, you know, beautiful lakes, The men are sitting in there and swimming, and the ladies are completely covered up.
Yes.
You know, there's no sun getting in them. Yeah. There's no air.
Yes.
You know, and I crossing the street with this. I mean, can you hear car horns properly?
Yes.
I mean, it's just, I personally, I'm hoping that my film will awaken women. I hope it'll make women understand that it's time to give this up.
Yes.
And it's time to evolve.
Yes.
And the power, we can no longer leave it in the hands of the men. We should now voice ourselves.
Yes.
And we should take action
in a positive manner. Very true.
So.
Women need to be educated. And with this, it's impossible. We need to have women being involved with the community.
Exactly.
And yes. And we are living in the 21st century. And I interviewed one of the American professors in Vancouver from Sudan. And he said, Sharia law is in Canada. Watch it. They are here. And be careful that you don't lose your human right, because if women walk like with at the beach with those kind of things, should be stoned to death or some other stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So Sharia law is getting all around the world, and it's in Canada.
Well, then it's a virus, and we need to find an antidote for it.
Yes. For that purpose, I suggest people get to watch her movie and support Afghan women, Iranian women, Afghan women, all women around the world. This is 21st century, and we have to stand for our rights. If we lose it, it takes life to come back. Okay? Tune with us.
We should evolve together, men
yes.
and women together.
And one more time, where is and when is your movie?
My film is playing at the DOXA Documentary Film Festival Thursday night, May the 10th, which happens to be my mother's birthday at Granville Theatre downtown.
So we'll see you there.
Yeah, I look forward to it. Thank you very much, Ebby.
Thank you for joining us, and thank you for watching. We'll see you then.